أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد.
صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector and curer. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. All slaves of Allah, first and foremost I enjoin upon myself and then all of you all who have come here to adopt a life of taqwa. For it is only through a life filled with taqwa, filled with the consciousness of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can a believer attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. May Allah the Almighty make us all from the people of taqwa. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, indeed, all of us, we live in uneasy times. In times where our hearts have become of stone. For this dunya has fooled us with her phony ways of pleasure. Our hearts have become so stony that we are not even ready to accept the inevitable terminator of all pleasures, which is death. Verily, the excessive remembrance of death pierces through the fake ways of pleasure of this dunya. It brings us closer to Allah the Almighty. It makes us involved in deeds that please our powerful maker. May Allah the Almighty accept all of our good deeds. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, today we thought of basing today's khutbah on the topic, the horrors of the judgment day. Because indeed, the day of judgment is extremely, extremely near. Allah the Almighty, He says in the Noble Quran, إِنَّ السَّاعَةَ لَآتِيَةٌ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Indeed, the hour, it is on its way. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهَا. There is no doubt in it. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. But most of mankind do not believe in it. Allahu Akbar. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, modern day scientists from the Muslim world, they analyze the ayat that talk about the day of Qiyamah. And they have drawn up a few conclusions, which to some extent may be true. They say, Allah the Almighty, when He talks about the Sa'ah, when He talks about the last hour, the day of judgment, Allah the Almighty says in the Noble Quran in another place, وَمَا أَمْرُ السَّاعَةِ إِلَّا كَلَمْحِ الْبَصَرِ. The command of Allah in regard to the day of judgment, it will come, إِلَّا كَلَمْحِ الْبَصَرِ. It will come in no other way other than كَلَمْحِ الْبَصَرِ. The word used here, لَمْحِ الْبَصَرِ, means the glance of an eye. The glance of an eye, or the sparkling of an eye. In another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even faster than that. The command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in regard to the day of Qiyamah would come so sudden, so fast, that these scientists, they say that it can only come at the speed of light. And what is the speed of light? 300,000 kilometers per second. 300,000 kilometers per second, the speed of light. And likewise, the speed of light can make 7.5 rotations of the earth in 1 second. This is the speed of light. So they say that no modern technology, no radar system can ever detect the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala coming to destroy this world. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Haqqah,
فَإِذَا نُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ نَفْخَةٌ وَاحِدًا وَحُمِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ وَالْجِبَالُ فَدُكَّتَا دَكَّةً وَاحِدًا
فَدُكَّتَا دَكَّةً وَاحِدًا. It is indeed a serious topic, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. فَإِذَا نُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ نَفْخَةٌ وَاحِدًا. When the sur, which we shall discuss as we go, inshallah ta'ala, when the sur is blown, نَفْخَةٌ وَاحِدًا, one blow, that blow would result in حُمِلَةِ الْأَرْضُ وَالْجِبَالِ, the earth and the mountains being lifted up. فَدُكَّتَا دَكَّةً وَاحِدًا. And then the whole earth would be leveled back with one blow. With one blow. So they say, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that this blow would hit the earth so hard and so fast, لا تأتيكم إلا بغتة. In another place Allah the Almighty says that it would not come upon you except it would come suddenly. You would not expect it. It would come so sudden. So sudden. Like I said, at the speed of light, none of us would be expecting it. This blow would collide with planet Earth, resulting in the planet being pushed off course and start twisting clockwise. Because currently, it is on its, in a sense, spinning on its axis counterclockwise, anticlockwise. This would result in the blow coming and hitting it and starting to turn the other way around. The other way around. And this, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, would result in so many changes. In so many changes. Allah says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرُ. When this happens, فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرُ, our sight will be dazzled. Our sight will be dazzled.
فَإِذَا بَرِقَ الْبَصَرُ وَخَسَفَ الْقَمَرُ.
The moon would lose its light.
وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ.
The sun and the moon would become one. Allahu Akbar. Scientists say today, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that just in case, hypothetically, if the sun were to burst in an explosion, it would result in the sun enveloping planet Venus and the moon altogether. It would become such a big ball of fire. Such a big ball of fire. So Allah the Almighty says in the Noble Quran, وَجُمِعَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ. On that day, the moon and the sun will become one. Allahu Akbar. The heat will be so unbearable. Just imagine the sun were to become bigger. If it even were to move an inch away from where Allah the Almighty has stipulated it to be, we know that planet Earth would burn to ashes. Would burn to ashes. It is not a big deal for Allah the Almighty, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Just think of it, when the sun becomes equivalent to the moon too. Allah says in another place in the Noble Quran,
وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ.
And on that day, the ocean will be as if they are on fire. The word used here, sujjarat, means that self-combustion will take place in the water. Now how can that be? How can water self-combust? Water consists, the molecule of water consists of hydrogen and oxygen. But remember, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, we are talking about a blow. A blow. دُكَّةِ الْأَرْضُ دَكَّةِ. We're talking about a blow. Right after the blow, due to the severity of the blow, the molecules in the water would decompose. Hydrogen would separate from oxygen, and hydrogen would burst into flames due to the existence of another particle known as oxygen. Water would become like lava. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ. All signs, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, these are events which would occur simultaneously with the blowing of the trumpet. Allahu Akbar. And remember, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, there is no necessity for these events to take place one after the other with huge intervals. No. If Allah the Almighty wishes, He could make it happen all at once, in a second. Just imagine if a huge asteroid or something were to hit planet Earth, would we be able to protect ourselves? Would the superpowers, so-called superpowers, be able to protect themselves? No, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Now let us look at a few events that would occur with the blowing of the trumpet. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, the reason we intend to discuss on this is for us to imagine the things happening right before us, so that it fills our hearts with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with taqwa, so that we do not forget that the day of Qiyamah is around the corner, so that we begin to prepare ourselves to meet our powerful Maker. In regard to the sur, hadith is in Tirmidhi, an Arab, a Bedouin, he comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asks him about the sur. What is the sur? فَإِذَا نُفِقَ فِي السُّورِ. What is this sur? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains to that man along the lines of this word, قَرْنٌ يُنْفَقُ فِيهِ. It is a trumpet like a horn which would be blown into. Hadith is in Tirmidhi, class Sahih by Shaykh Albani rahimahullah. He says it is a trumpet like a horn which will be blown into. Now how many blasts will be blown into this trumpet? And also, a point to be noted is that this particular trumpet has already been placed on the lips of Israfil alayhi salam, who has been given the responsibility of blowing the trumpet. He has already placed it on his lips. He is waiting for the command of the Almighty Allah to blow the trumpet. Allahu Akbar. The proximity, all of this highlights the proximity. How close the day of Qiyamah is to us, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Most of the scholars are of the opinion that there will be three blows on that horn. Three blows, three blasts. The first blast would be, it's known as Nafkhatul Faza', the blow of fear. This blow, the minute Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands Israfil alayhi salatu wa salam, he will blow the trumpet, resulting in the whole creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being filled with fear. We would all tremble the minute we hear this blow. We would all tremble. We would wonder as to where this huge sound has come from. This would be the first blow. Hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrates, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is reported to have said, ما بين النفختين أربعون. ما بين النفختين أربعون. Between the two blows in the trumpet, there will be 40. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, there will be 40. The صحابة رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين, they asked أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه, يا أبا هريرة, أربعون يوما, will it be 40 days? Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu replied, Abayt. They asked him, Arba'una shahra, Abayt. Arba'una sana, Abayt. Allahu Akbar. They asked Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, will it be 40 days? He says, I refuse to determine that. Will it be 40 months? I refuse that too. Will it be 40 years? I refuse that too. He indicates, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, that he refuses to determine that statement due to him not asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah knows best in regard to this 40, whether it will be 40 minutes, 40 days, 40 months, or 40 years. Nevertheless, there will be 40 between the first blow and the second blow. Now what is the second blow? The second blow is known as Nafkhatul Saq. Nafkhatul Saq. Allah the Almighty mentions in regard to this blow in the Noble Quran, وَنُفِقَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ وَنُفِقَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. This blow will be blown, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Every single creation in the heavens and the earth will fall dead. Allahu Akbar. This is known as Nafkat al-Saq or Nafkat al-Maut. Due to this blow on the trumpet, every single creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fall down dead, illa man shaa Allah. Except those creations Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has exempted. Now who are these creations? Ulama of the opinion, some of them say they are the malaika. Some of them say they are the malaika. At this very point, when the trumpet is blown, they will be exempted. Some of the other ulama say it will be Israfil, alayhi salam, himself, who is blowing the trumpet. He will not die at that point, that moment. Some of the ulama say Hamalatul Arsh, the angels who are carrying the arsh of Ar-Rahman, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because there is a hadith. Hadith is in Bayhaqi, Tabari, and Tabarani. It is known as Hadith al-Surah Tawil. Hadith al-Surah Tawil. In this hadith, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that after this blow on the trumpet, Malakul Maut would go straight to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he would inform Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hadith go along the lines of these words. He would inform Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, all of your creation have passed away. They have all died. Except for Jibreel, Mikael, Israfil, Hamalatul Arsh, and myself, alayhi salatu wasalam. These are the angels who remain behind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that Malakul Maut will go and inform Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty, strictly moving on this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would command, let death come to Jibreel, alayhi salatu wasalam. And Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam will fall down dead. Just think of it. All of us, petty creations, we are all destroyed. The malaika, only they remain. And Allah the Almighty will say, let death come to Jibreel, let death come to Mikael, let death come to Israfil, let death come to the Hamalatul Arsh. All of them will fall one by one. Finally, Malakul Maut will go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, Ya Allah, it is only you and I who remain. Malakul Maut and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah the Almighty will say, O Malakul Maut, I created you for a purpose. I created you for a duty. You have fulfilled your duty. Let death come to you too. Malakul Maut will also fall down dead. Only Allah the Almighty will remain. Allahu Akbar. Allah the Almighty, in all of His creations, Allah the Almighty, He will remain. Every single thing will be destroyed. Kullu shay'in halikun illa wajha. All of the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of them, every single thing will be destroyed. And what will remain? Who will remain? Illa wajha, the face of Allah. Only Allah the Almighty would remain. He is the beginning and He is the end. هو الأول والآخر الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد. Only He will remain. And at that point, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Allah the Almighty will question, لمن الملك اليوم؟ لمن الملك اليوم؟ لمن الملك اليوم؟ Today, on this very day, for whom is the kingdom? For whom is the dominion? For whom is all of this kingship? There will be no one to answer. Where are the dictators? Where are the oppressors? Where are the superpowers? Where are the presidents? No one will remain. Everyone will be destroyed, my respected elders and brothers in Islam. Allah the Almighty will reply Himself, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارُ. The kingdom, the dominion, belongs to Allah, the one, the prevailing. No one else will remain, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. So after this blow on the trumpet, Allah the Almighty would make a rain descend on earth, on the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hadith is in Muslim, يُنزِلُ اللَّهُ مَطَرًا كَأَنَّهُ الطَّلِ. Allah the Almighty would make a rain descend, that rain would be as if it is dew. فَتَنْبُتُ مِنْهُ أَجْسَادُ النَّاسِ. And due to that rain, the bodies of mankind would begin to tumble, it would begin to flourish. It would begin to rejuvenate again. It would begin to revive itself due to that rain. And then, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, will be the third and final blow on the trumpet. And this blow is known as Nafsatul Ba'th. It is the blow of resurrection. When this blow is blown, Allahu Akbar. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا. When the earth will be shook with its final shaking. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. And earth would put out its burden, i.e. the bodies which it has kept within itself, all of the graves would be turned up, all of the graves would split open, crack open. وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. Mankind would say, what is wrong with her? What is wrong with us? يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. And on that day, the earth would start narrating of all the events that took place upon earth. All of the sins, all of the crimes, all of the transgressions, and likewise all of the good deeds. بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَالَهَا. With that which Allah the Almighty had decreed, had willed, had commanded the earth to discharge and inform. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَسْرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا. And on that day, mankind would divide themselves into ashtata groups, لِيَرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ, to see their deeds, or for their deeds to be shown unto them. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ. And whoever has done an atom's weight of good, definitely he shall see it. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. And likewise, whoever has done an atom's weight of evil, an atom's weight of bad, he will also see it. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Al-Qari'ah, wa adraka mal-Qari'ah. Al-Qari'ah, the striking calamity. Mal-Qari'ah, what is this striking calamity? وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَالْقَارِيَةِ. And what will make you understand, what will make you perceive this striking calamity? يَوْمَ يَكُونُ النَّاسُ كَالْفَرَّاشِ الْمَبْثُوثِ. Allahu Akbar. It is a day in which mankind will be like moth dispersed, thrown about here and there. وَتَكُونُ الْجِبَالُ كَالْعِجْنِ الْمَنْفُوشِ. And on that day, mountains will be like wool, all fluffed up. Allahu Akbar. It is on this day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, after the third blow on the trumpet, the graves will split open, mankind will come out. Just imagine. This is a scene all of us have to imagine. We have to think about it. All of us, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, on that day the graves will split open and all of us will come out one after the other. One after the other. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that we will come out of the grave hufatan, barefooted, quratan, naked, ghurla, uncircumcised. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. All of us, from Adam alayhi salatu wasalam until the last man to be created on the face of this earth, we will all be there on that plane. All of us would come out of our graves. Just imagine, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Aisha, radiallahu anha, asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, men and women, naked just like that, would we be ashamed? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Ya Aisha, radiallahu anha, on that day the matter will be so severe, so frightening, so scary, that no one will have time or no one will be bothered to look at one another. Allahu Akbar. None of us will be bothered. All of us would start coming out of the grave to respond to the Nafkhatul Ba'th, the call of resurrection. وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ. And with every soul there will be two angels. A sa'iq, one who would push them forward, وَشَهِيدٌ, and a witness. And all of the souls, all of us, all of our souls would return to our bodies And we would come out of our grave and we will be driven towards Ardul Mahshar. Towards Ardul Mahshar. Towards the land of gathering. Towards the land of gathering. Now in regard to this land, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that it is a land like none other. It is a land like none other. It is a land which will be like a white plain. Like a white plain with a reddish tinge. The soil of that land will be as if it is fine flour. Fine flour. A white plain with a reddish tinge. It will be like a white loaf of bread. And no human would know that land. We would not be able to identify that land. There will be no time for us to identify that land. We will be driven towards Ardul Mahshar. We would be driven towards Ardul Mahshar. These two malaika, they would push and probe us forward. Allahu Akbar. And now what will happen? All of us, just imagine, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, naked, barefooted, uncircumcised, probed and pushed forward towards Ardul Mahshar. And does it end there? No. Now the sun begins to descend. Allahu Akbar. The sun begins to descend. And to what extent? Bimiqdari meal. The sun would come down. The hadith goes along the lines of these words to the equivalent of a meal. The Arabic term used meal can be translated as the English mile, a unit of length, mile, or else meal is also used for the stick we use to apply surma. For the stick we use to apply kuhal. How big is that stick? This big? The size of my forefinger? Yes, perhaps. Whatever said and done, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, whether it be 1 mile or whether it be equivalent to the stick of the surma, just imagine how close the sun would be. It would roast us. It would roast us. We would be naked. We would be barefooted. Standing in on the Ardul Mahshar and the sun so close. And now what would happen? We would begin to sweat. We would sweat so profusely that some of us, due to our sins, each person in accordance to his sins, some until they are healed, they will be drowning in their sweat. Some till their knees, some till their hips, some till their chest, and some due to the excess of their sins, due to the heavy baggage that they have brought, the sweat will cover their mouth. Allah save us all. Allah save us all. Allah save us on the day of Qiyamah. The sweat would cover our mouth. And does it end there, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam? A final narration. Mankind will be in utter confusion. Mankind will be at a loss. Mankind will not know what to do. Where are we to run? How are we to hide? There is nowhere to run. We are in front of our beloved, our powerful Maker. Where are we to run? If we are not ready to meet him, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, we are indeed unfortunate if we are not ready to meet him. Mankind will be in confusion, and in that fear, they will start bickering amongst themselves. Let's go to someone to seek help. The hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, along the lines of these words. Someone would say, let's go to Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. Let's go to Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. All of mankind would rush to Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. Ya Adam! Ya Adam alayhi salatu wassalam! You are the first human to be created. Allah the Almighty commanded the malaika to prostrate unto you. You are indeed privileged. Do you see the calamity that has befallen us? We are under the heat of the sun. We are sweating. It's such a scary spectacle. Intercede on behalf of us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know what Adam alayhi salatu wa salam would say? Adam alayhi salatu wa salam would say, O people, my Lord has become so angry that I have never ever seen him this angry, nor do I think that he will ever become angry like this. And I do not dare to intercede because I disobeyed him in regard to the command of the fruit of that tree. Nafsi, nafsi, nafsi. I'm only worried about myself. I cannot help you all. Please go to Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam. Go to Nuh alayhi salatu wassalam.
Mankind rushes to Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. Ya Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, you were the first messenger to be sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Intercede on behalf of us, Ya Nuh. Do you see the difficulty we are in? Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam would reply the same reply. Allah is so angry. I have never seen him this angry. Nor do I see him, nor do I think that he will ever become angry like this. Nafsi, nafsi, nafsi. I prayed against my nation. I do not dare face Allah the Almighty. Go to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Go to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Mankind rushes to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam would also reply, Nafsi, nafsi, nafsi. Go to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Mankind would then rush to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam would say, Nafsi, nafsi, nafsi. Go to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Mankind would then rush to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam would also reply, Nafsi, nafsi, nafsi. I cannot help you all. Go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Please remember salawat whenever I mention his beautiful name. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, on that day, every single human being would know the value of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mankind would rush to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah! We are in a big problem. Please help us. Intercede on behalf of us, Ya Rasulullah. And you know what our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say? Yes, I can do it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would not say, Nafsi, nafsi, nafsi. On a day, Yawma yafirru al-mar'u min akhin wa ummi wa abi وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه. On a day, a man would run away from his own brother, from his own mother, from his own father, from his parents, from his beloved wife, from his children, only worried about himself, because he would fear if he goes to his father might take his good deeds. If he goes to his wife might blame him and take his good deeds. On that day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would go to the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would fall down in sajda. He would start praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, words would come to me to praise Allah. Those words never have come to me. But on that day, at that point, these words would come and I would begin to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then it will be announced, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, irfa ra'sak, irfa ra'sak, irfa ra'sak. واشفع تشفع. الله أكبر. يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, lift your head, lift your head. You ask and it will be given to you. You ask, it will be given to you. You intercede and your intercession will be accepted. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. And you know what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم will say? Ya Rab, أمتي, 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 my nation, my nation, my nation. But today that nation has forgotten our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We claim to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but we haven't adopted his life as our life. We claim to love him. We have lectures, we have conferences, claiming to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But in reality, we haven't freed ourselves from innovation. We haven't turned to him. We haven't adopted his life as our life. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. He would cry out, Ya Allah, my nation, my nation. Give preference to us, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. On that day, all of mankind would understand the value of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if the Ummah Muhammadiyya
If we, the Ummah of our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do not understand his value, if we waste our time, just hot air, that we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but we are not ready to bring in his sunan into our lives, rather we are involved in unnecessary innovation. What is the point, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam? There is no point having debate. There is no point arguing that we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but rather live the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to prove your love for him. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, our attempt today was to give you a glimpse, a tiny glimpse. There is no way that we can actually portray the horrors of the Day of Judgment. Allahu Akbar, it is so scary. But it is upon us that this reminder strikes a chord of fear in all of our hearts, so that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in true tawbah before it is too late, before the doors of tawbah are slammed shut. And likewise, let us adopt the life of our Master sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as our life, and let us bring in true love for him, free of all innovation, true love for him, and let us love him and follow him, for it is only through his life that we can attain success in this world and the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. May Allah the Almighty accept all of our good deeds. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our hearts with true love for our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah the Almighty help us to prepare to meet him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to prepare for the last day, the Day of Judgment. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite all of us in the gardens of Jannah with our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.